Okay, it's March 29th, 2018. It's 11:36 a.m. I was gonna walk out to the mailbox. I have a hat on, and I have to put my face mask on now because, like I said, as much as I can, I got away from that, and I've been feeling crappy, see? And I'm sorry. You know, call it paranoid, whatever you want, man. When I try to get a video, if I can remember to do it at nighttime, with a straight, strong stream of light, and show you what's coming out of the skies. In the daytime, you just don't see it because it's, you know, daytime. You want to come out here? It's raining a little bit. I got the dogs with me. You guys stay up on the porch if you want to. I'm going to go down here. I do have my face mask on here because I'm going to limit as much, so as little as possible, with as much as I have for Kim. Facial mask on. I have a hat on my head because I don't want the spitting of the aluminum laced rain coming down on me. Again, look at the trees. Look at all that. We've been here 6 years. Never saw that shit. And it's on all the trees now. It's on all the trees. And anybody said, well, that's just this or it's just that, you know, just roll over and enjoy the wet, soaked panties that you have on. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I guess. The mailman closed our mailbox. The wind had blown it open. And I thought, well, maybe he put mail out here and it gets wet. So, therefore, I forgot to come out here and get the mail before it didn't get soaked because it's going to start raining hard later today. But, see, now this has been, again, another part of 2 or 3 weeks where it rains for 3 to 4 days in a week. And it comes on hard. The ground is saturated. It's soaked. It's soft almost. And you guys stay over this way. I'm going to walk over toward the garden a little bit. Oh, my goodness. It's just so saturated. I got two elderberry bush / trees in the back over by that green swing frame. One on each side, 5 feet out from each side, north and south. And you look at the garden, how it's got puddles in there and everything. We're not going to put that hay down because of weeds and such. We tilled up the southern part of the western part of number 3 back there. Number 3 is in the back, yeah, 1 and 2. And we were going to let go. We have to till it all up again, and then we're going to put the plastic down. And I don't know if the wind is cutting out the mic, which it probably is. You didn't hear half what I just said. Get by the porch here. Hi, Lucy. I'm gonna say it again over here. Okay. Let me clean off this lens. It's got rain on it. Okay. We tilled the north west corner of number 3. 1, 2, and 3 is in the back. And of the northwest corner, we just did the southern half of that. So we gotta till up. We're gonna till up all of it. You know, so this is all when it gets dry, which might be, you know, July. You know, but soon. I even went through the outer, my sunflower barrier, which is a giant U. If you ever looked on Google Maps, unfortunately, I've given up the address a couple times in the past. You'll see it's a giant U that goes around the whole garden. Over there, there's a break, and it comes out further on the west end over there, coming south from there. And it was also going to be so hard. I have leaves that's been down there since last week, last year, fall, around October, November-ish. And I tilled it beforehand, then I put the leaves on there, like I said, and then I went through with tilling. It's all muddy because, you know, all this rain. Everything's staying flooded. I really do expect the flood to, you know, we give you under flood warning or something. But the northeast corner on everything is flooded, so when we till again, we're going to have to try moving the soil over to that corner area and build it up a little bit before we put down plastic. But we are going to put plastic on all this. The beans, this one right here, number 2 garden, which is on the southeast part, will be all beans and peas. Back over there, okra, and not sure. We're going to have basil on the outer edge of number 3 on the west east end. And tomatoes and peppers. And don't know what we're going to go further, but on the far left, on the western end, it'll be watermelon, cantaloupe, and in the middle, more or less, cucumbers. So we got other things we're going to put out. So that's, I just wanted to show, again, all these trees. These are pin oak and black oak trees right here. Look at their tree trunks. I know the wind's got to be cutting this mic out. So, even that over there, that pecan tree. Oh, gosh, man. We are in so much trouble, folks. You got to depend on yourself. The person that looks at you in the mirror, that's the only person you'll ever, ever really be able to count on. So.